Do you feel your slides don't look interesting enough to engage your audience? I can understand. You slog the whole day to create the slides for your presentation. The slide deck looks good. And the D-Day comes. You open the slide deck and to your horror, you realize that the slides look so meh. Suddenly, the fear sets in that your audience will totally ignore your slides and you will stand there on the stage looking like a complete bore. Does it happen to you? At least it used to happen to me all the time when I started my career in a bank. I lived through the nightmare for years till I discovered a simple technique that changed the game for me. I call it the 1% technique. That one technique made such an impact that I chose to make my entire career around creating presentations. Want to know more about the technique? Then keep watching. I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We help you confidently create engaging PowerPoint presentations so you achieve the growth you deserve in your professional life. I discovered the 1% technique quite by accident while randomly browsing through a book on ad copywriting, where the author says, "Good writing is rewriting." Here is how the technique works. You don't stress yourself too much to create the perfect slide deck the first time. You start by quickly creating your boring first draft. Then you keep making small revisions to the deck to see how you can improve the slide by just 1% each time. It's like playing a game with your slides. In fact, why don't we play the game right now to see how dramatically we can change the look and feel of your slides with this 1% technique. Let's take this slide for example. We have some text and a cutout image. I'm sure you've seen slides like this used in professional presentations, right?
Yeah, it looks good.
Let's see if we can improve this first draft by 1%. Right away, I can see a problem here. The image seems to be floating in space. So we need to give it a stable base. One thing I do regularly to convert 2D images to 3D is to add a floor and a shadow. Let's see if it works here. For the floor, let me draw a rectangle and give it a gray color. I can then add a perspective shadow to the picture. Now the image looks stable.
Yeah, the slide looks good now. We can stop.
No, let's see if we can make it better. Here, I can see a common rookie mistake in selecting the image for the slide. The presenter picked the default front-on view for the image. It's so boring. What if we try a different angle for the image? Now, this allows us to place another character in the scene. They can have a conversation. Plus, this image matches the content of the slide better.
Yeah, now the slide looks good. We can stop now.
No, let's see if we can make it even better. These two people seem to be standing in a vacuum. Now, what if we add a background and make the scene more natural? This is a free image I got from Pixabay. Now, see this. The same slide looks so much more lively with the right background.
Yeah, this slide looks really good. We can settle for it.
Can we make this even better? But before that, remember, what I'm demonstrating to you is not how to make over this particular slide. I'm sharing with you an example of the mindset you need to make the 1% approach work. Coming back to the slide, instead of using these usual side angle images of these two people, what if we change the angle a bit to involve the audience? Here, the main subject faces the audience. So you can frame the question as a dialogue by the main character. This allows you to ask the audience to give their answers before you reveal yours. This makes the presentation more interactive, don't you think?
Yeah, this is too good, Ramgopal. Let's stop here.
But can we make this even better? Now on this slide, I can see that the second character is occupying a lot of visual space and is distracting. How can we solve that problem? What if I blur the second image? That's great. Now the focus is entirely on the main character. If you wonder about how to get these ideas to make the 1% improvement, I'll share with you a free resource to do just that in a moment. As you work with this 1% technique, sometimes you might stumble upon ideas that make a huge shift in the look and feel of your slides. For example, this slide with a quote can be instantly made punchier by just focusing on the face and cropping out everything else.
This 1% improvement can make you a master in presentations.
The slides you make with this approach look satisfying even years after making them.
To help you apply the 1% approach, we have put together a useful free mini training called 25 Creative Ideas for Professional Presentations. You can click on the link right here to sign up for the free course. Go ahead, click on the link and explore the ideas right away.